Hey, what's up, good people? It's me, Angga, back with a whole tech review, and today let's talk about the Samsung Gear S3. It seems like everyone is talking about how the smartwatch market is collapsing. But is this excuse made Samsung skip the generation and introducing new lineup Samsung wearables to attract consumer for another big things that we can do on our smartwatch? Well, I think... Years ago, a Tizen-powered Gear S3 was full of good ideas, from the improvement of the rotating bezel that was introduced in its predecessor, Gear S2, and its compatibility with non-Samsung Android phones. This wearable was full of feature a years ago, but is Samsung really polishing what they call an innovation the time when this wearable was released? Let's talk about the hardware. The Gear S3 is an eye-catching and well-constructed device compared to any other smartwatches out there.
With those circular and classy design made the device look like a normal watch. I like how Samsung made the design like a normal watch in general. Maybe a smartwatch in circular design will need some learning curve to adapt and use. But that's what makes the watch really unique because it stands between classic and modern approach. At first, sometimes many people will be mistaken the Gear S3 as a normal watch. But they will eventually notice the great function behind it when a notification pops out and you play with the watch. I've been using this watch for 1 year and I can say the durability of the build is top notch. It is sturdy and I can barely see a minimal scratch on the metallic stainless steel body. The 360x360 Corning Gorilla Glass is vivid on this small footprint, and that Super AMOLED display did a commendable job on bright sunlight. The classic version that I have is not an LTE capable. I mostly use the watch to track down my activity throughout the day. The 1GHz dual-core Exynos processor, 768MB of RAM still can handle everything you do, and the IP68 waterproofing also helps the watch to stay durable. I think the 4GB of internal storage by far is a fair implementation by Samsung, because back in 2016 I wasn't using the storage that much, but now, when I put some apps, well, not too many, and some other high-quality downloadable Spotify music, it says I only have 1.2GB available space with 2.8GB of used storage. I think it's too small now, considering how the system and apps took so many spaces.
In the software department, the Gear S3 runs Tizen OS version 2.3.1 out of the box, and it's been updated to the latest version of 3.0.0.2.
And as usual, it is very smartly laid out to take the advantage of that wonderful spinning bezel.
The underlying Tizen platform, however, means you won't find any great apps. But according to Samsung, they have something like 10,000 apps in the Tizen store. But honestly,
I found most of the apps are not really that interesting and useful. Even it missed so many integrated apps from big name developer that can work seamlessly with phone like WhatsApp, Line, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and note-taking apps like Evernote are still absent on Tizen OS. Most of the apps also barely update. But yeah, I know it's been more than a year since it released, and it's supposed to improve in so many ways on the software department, and I really don't see the voice command that useful. I mean, the S voice is very stiff in conversation, which makes you sound like a robot, unlike Google Assistant and Siri, which can communicate with flow and flexible to use.
Of course, Siri and Google Assistant was on the same situation in the past year, but they've been improved in so many ways until today. But what about Samsung S Voice? The battery life so far so good. I don't see much change on the battery life since the latest version firmware update.
The 380 mAh battery will give you a pretty decent amount of battery life. And the truth is, you will easily get a couple of days use out of this watch.
With the Gear S3, I think Samsung did a pretty good job on building a wearable with a little something for everyone. The device still falls short in a lot of ways, including its overzealous automatic fitness tracking and a limited app selection even after a year.
The Gear S3 was Samsung evolved to make a complementary accessory for smartphone, and they began to give LTE antenna for some other variant, but lack of good implementation in software department. And at the end of the day, nothing special of this smartwatch, but only the design make this watch stand out. With so few truly interesting smartwatch option out there, the Gear S3 can't help but feels like a refreshing change of pace.
If you are in the market of a high-end wearable and don't care about Tizen, well, the Gear S3 is worth considering.
Even after almost 2 years, the Gear S3 still stands against competitors like Apple Watch Series 3, Android Wear, and other high-end smart wearable choices like Fitbit and Garmin.
Recently, Samsung released a new successor for the Gear S3, and the company called it Samsung Galaxy Watch. Yes, the product name is different, but it is just a typical marketing gimmick from Samsung. With all of this new release, I believe you can find a pretty good deals for the Samsung Gear S3. Well, I think we just have to wait until then. Alright guys, that's pretty much everything. Please like the video if you like it, and don't forget to subscribe if you love it. See you guys on the next one.